Welcome in for our TechStar Kubota post-game interview, the second year head coach of the Texans, Chris Reisman. Coach, let's start and let's talk about the first half. You're trailing 36-34 in the second half. What went wrong there and what did you want to correct at the half?
Well, I thought we were letting that point guard number 11, Lombard, get in the paint way too easily. You know, I have a very aggressive style defensively and almost backfired. Bethany likes to get up in you. The kid was a transfer from Colorado. He's a good player.
Sure.
And he kept putting us in situations where we were scrambling. We were over-rotating. We were over-helping. And I thought the difference in the second half is we really backed off and did a good job mixing up ball screen coverages against him. And I really just said, hey, shoot the ball from the perimeter. Also, transition defense there at times in the first half. We weren't getting back. We were getting offensive rebounds. They were getting putbacks. Of their 14 makes, 8 were layups. And I said, hey, guys, you got to make them beat you from the perimeter. I thought we did a much better job protecting the basket, protecting the rim, and making them work to get tough shots.
Visiting with Chris Reisman here, our TechStar Kubota post-game interview. You come out and you get that 14-0 run, and then you actually, the run extended to 22-9 to start the first half. Just talk about that run and the energy that guys like Clayshawn brought.
I thought we had a lot of great unselfish play during that run. I thought we talked about getting the ball size, making Metro guard us, not trying to score so much on the first side, and we did that, and we had guys that were sacrificing good shots for great shots. And when you start knocking down shots, it's contagious, Casey, and you saw that. The bench was into it. The players were into it. That's the type of basketball that I want to play. And I thought that was what, like you said, we break it open. We moved the ball side to side. We weren't turning it over, and we were taking great shots.
Yeah, Randall Brody, coach, really got hot from behind the line, 4 of 9. And you go back to last season, he had 45 points in the last two games last season. So he's had 63 points in 3 games. Is he starting to come into his own?
I'm going to tell you, Brody had a rough preseason. He did not play well in any of our 3 scrimmages. And him and I had a very long talk about, hey, we're going to change some routines up, and you're going to have to come and play like a senior, or I'm going to have to go with somebody else. And I think that motivated him. He got in the gym. He was in the gym early every day this week, sometimes staying late and getting extra shots. And, man, work pays off. I mean, that's sure. The bottom line. The secret's in the dirt, like Jason Witten says. And he put in work, and he can see that he's a player. And I'm really happy for him because he's a guy that he acknowledges – he acknowledges the coaching staff. He acknowledges teammates. He'll look you in the eye. He wants to win. You can see it. My big thing for Brody is going forward when the adversity hits, battling and trusting the process. Sure. And today was a good day for him, and we need him to continue to play well.
Metro State went on a little run there at the end of the game. I know they started to press, and you turn it over to you. Do you look much into that? I mean, how much does that disappoint you, or is that just a byproduct of how the game flow went?
I look into everything, Casey.
I know you do.
I want to, you know, we worked hard. We wanted to keep this team in the 60s, and we have to finish games better. And we have to understand at the end of the game when you got a big lead, you're not going to get certain calls, and you got to play through it. And so hopefully this will be a learning tool for us going forward. But at the end of the day, Metro is going to have a very, very good season. They're well coached. They have good players over there.
Sure.
And so I'm happy anytime you go on the road, even if it's a neutral game, to get a win. And you know what? Like I told my guys, there's no rest for the weary. We got to go home. We got the game plan. We got a 2 o'clock game tomorrow. And, you know, we've prepared for this. We've been doing 6:30 Monday night practices with 8 a.m. list to 1:30 practice. I mean, they're going to be ready, but they got to come out mentally ready.
Coach, congratulations. It's the 8th consecutive season opening win for Tarleton against a really historic program in Metro State. Congrats.
Thanks, Casey. I want to thank Texan Nation. Had quite a few people that came up and made the trip. Also want to say hello to my son, Rush Reisman, who's at home. Thank you.